see this.
Bad news, folks. I just went over 5G for my data plan. Oh. I just got a message, and so I will be slow. I might have no video sometimes. So anyway, I had just, I think, gotten most of it, except for you just said that Liz's picture was there.
Yeah.
And they love Liz in the Oregonian.
They do. They love. She's the little poster girl in the movie.
Yeah. Well, she really is, as they say, the iconic photograph. Yeah. That's the Time magazine photograph of
Well,
Occupy.
No, it's not just that. I remember her, you know, when she had an arm in the barrel. And I remember her when she was first, when she first came and started doing peace and safety. And then she worked her way, like, up to running the desk at night. And she was pretty much always, like, the one at the desk at peace and safety at the camp. And I always thought, for a young lady, she's pretty tough, and I've seen her de-escalate some serious issues as well. So I always gave her a lot of credit. Her and Emily was also on peace and safety, and Emily was only 18, and she would show up and walk up and down the paths from B camp all the time around the kids' camp and the library to make sure it was, you know, decently safe.
Trying to place Emily. I know an Emily.
Just troopers. So yeah, Liz made her name with me long before she got sprayed in the mouth, so.
Right. Yeah.
I just hope she continues to do what she was doing with her arm in the barrel, as they use that to win.
Are you talking about the cement, cement
barrel.
The whatever kids, what were they called? The something kids. Anyway.
Yeah.
That was amazing. That was amazing.
Right.
So, well, I'm very sad about my data plan not allowing me. I mean, I am spending buku money to go to 5 gigabyte from 2, and I had no idea that I would have, anyway, in for a penny, in for a pound.
Pretty
in
much.
For a pounding.
That's funny you should say that, because I was thinking about that this morning, that Barry saying.
Yeah?
Like, yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Well, what do you think about this... this occupation we got tonight. Look at this. There's a lot of people here.
There was a lot of people tonight. I think the bike swarm was here for a while,
cool.
too. I think a lot of people were here.
That was cool.
Yeah, and the food was great.
Yeah. So Marjorie's, like, making every Tuesday special.
Every Tuesday, no, it's
yeah.
awesome.
So you guys know to come down on Tuesdays. What time does she come?
Usually about 8 o'clock.
8?
Tops.
Okay. Yeah. So, way to go. That's, that's what we need. We need something... Okay, you guys, here's a challenge. Give us a weekday. We got something on Tuesday. How about something on Thursday? You know, or how about something right before GA, like maybe 5-6 o'clock on Sunday? You know, we could have something. Marjorie's doing something once a week. If everybody did something once a week, we'd have people all the time, and people who aren't necessarily, you know, from Occupy.
I would like to see at least somewhere out here some information tables, because I think that if we
know, Mike, I was just talking about that.
I think we really need to
check this out. Okay, I'm gonna tell you too. You tell me what you think. You get a boat trailer or something narrow, like a bike trailer, but narrow, like a, you know, looking like a boat trailer, a big solid frame, but narrow. Park it there. We can put Mr. 60's box and 3 more. One will be an info, one will be community needs, one will be a food thing.
Right.
And maybe even more space for sleeping bags and mats and tarps and blankets. And that sits here at night because right here, you see that this is a loading zone. But all night long, even though it says 5 minutes or 15 minutes, it doesn't matter at night because that's only enforced during the day. So
what do you think?
We put that trailer here at night and lock everything down. In the daytime, if there's people here that are gonna man it, we'll take the carts off, and as long as they're on wheels, they can be out on the sidewalk if people are here.
Right.
And so we'll have the carts like we do, but they won't be chained up to anything. They'll just be here. And then we wheel the cart over the river right on the Hawthorne.
That's perfect.
And it can be there. So I met somebody. There's a guy named Ghost in Clackamas who I saw had this sweet kind of rig. And then I saw Colonel had something of a big frame, looked like the RV bicycle apparatus trailer. So we can definitely do it. And anyway, I'm fundraising for that.
I was saying that because I was talking to a couple of my friends about this the other day, well, today, for a bit. And they have some experience with sheet metal and a little bit of TIG welding and stuff like that. When we were talking about going ahead and manufacturing a few bike trailers.
So okay.
One that you can mount to any bike. A really easy one to mount to any bike. For different purposes. But the first ones we would try to build are something we could actually use to make money, to generate the money we need to make a business out of making trailers, because it takes money. So we would use the first couple of trailers to make money.
Well, what if we fundraised $100 for...
That would buy some of the materials.
Yeah, I want to do it, you know, on the cheap. So I'll have to find out, but would you please talk to your friends and see how much it would cost to build a trailer for cheap? And you know what? If you're going to try to make more and sell them, with some profit, we can always put your name of that business and website or whatever on it.
Yeah.
So
no,
that's
not what the only thing I'd want for it to do is to generate an income for the business of making trailers.
Right, so you can continue to make trailers.
So you can continue to make trailers.
So you're talking about a multiple trailer occupation.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You could actually make a nice business out of making trailers, customized trailers.
You know, you're reminding me of, what's his name? Dr. Evil. You're reminding me of his number two when he was saying, we manufacture these. And he's like, factories? No, models of factories.
Why do you have to be like that?
I don't know.
No, I just think, you know what? I don't care about making any money on any of that. I think it's a really good industry, like a co-op where you can get people actually making a living. I think it's important. Money doesn't matter, of course, right? Unless you don't have it.
Right.
So we all need money.
Let's that would be great. I mean, the occupation needs trailers. We need to do things on wheels.
Right.
We've talked about this since, November.
And it's June, and the summer's just begun, and it's going to be over in 3 months. It's time to really get on this shit.
Right.
And
we need to get more people involved, and the message of Occupy Portland to the greater community, and not just Portland, but down, around other neighborhoods. I know that Southeast had a huge Occupy, movement there. So other neighborhoods, Beaverton, I think, was it Northeast that had?
They're all over. Northeast is big. It's probably one of the fastest growing areas.
Have Portland. You been to their meetings?
You know, not per se, because I'm out of downtown.
Yeah. Well, it's hard to get to Northeast. I mean,
it's hard just to stay on track with what I've got going on,
right,
alone, what other people are doing.
Hey, speaking of what you've got going on, are you still doing that building? The one with you and Ram Justice?
That fell through, but there's always other buildings. I think next time I'll probably gear myself up towards maybe a lease or some kind of already finished building. There's no problems.
And the other thing is there was a bad break on the recall because you found out that you would have to do hundreds of thousands of signatures, right?
No. What it was is I had...
Or pay for it or something.
What I had done is filled out the paperwork, and I had spoken with the guy in here, the auditors, whatever. One guy was for the state doing all that recall stuff. He came out because I told him I was excluded, and so he came out, brought me the paperwork, and we went back and forth one day, and then I gave him the paperwork, and then he left saying, "Hey, this looks good. I'll call you with final approval." So he called me a couple hours later and said, "No, actually, there's this new rule that says that you have to start an ORSTAR campaign committee, and then have all your donations and all your expenditures and all your other things calculated and recorded just like a campaign. Plus you have to start a tech account. So things are a little different because of the legislature that passed as far as recall process. So yeah, I did file for the recall, but it was denied. And so then I got into this softball game thing. So now when I'm done with the other actions that I'm doing immediately, then I'll take a week, probably do a working vacation up in Mount Hood, come back and go ahead and get going on it.
Right on. So you are focused on this softball game. And yeah. How did your practice go?
It was awesome.
Was it?
Yeah.
Do you think that we have chance?
Oh, absolutely.
Really? So you got some players. Who's on the team?
I can't tell you because I'd have to shoot you.
Oh, shoot.
Twice.
Dang it.
I'd have to shoot in the first just
to and then to kill.
Teach you a lesson, that guy.
Teach me. Well, what if I learned the lesson? You don't have to kill me. You guys, wow. You just witnessed I had a death threat. I could fight Portland.
I guess I could go to prison in order for that. So
yeah. I'm not filing charges if you kill me.
Take this off the air.
Yeah, I will. I will as soon as live doesn't. To make me go back in time and erase it.
So, the softball game, here's what it's all about. I got really into the softball game because of this. Not that just because I love the Rangers and my, you know, relationship over the months with those guys, because they are pretty good people. But it's the fact that we're going for a recall campaign against Commissioner Fisher. And
the irony.
We are going to need all the support we can get.
Right.
So this is a great PR campaign,
right,
whether you like it or not. And,
oh, I do.
And I hope.
I love the fact. Did you see that the papers are saying, well, you know, it's people from the Rangers. It's not the institution of the
right.
Park Rangers. Because Parks and right. Rec are saying that they had a $130,000 bill from Occupy for the parks.
By the way,
so,
can I
yeah,
add this in?
Hilarious.
The other day before yesterday, right here, 15 feet from me, the girl, a higher up girl from the parks department, it's kind of separate from the park rangers, but they have offices, you know, around each other. So she's high up in the parks department and she's playing. Lots of people are playing. So actually the parks department and the park rangers are playing. So it's not just the park rangers now, it's the park. Maintenance department. Just the
wow.
Parks department.
Parks department is playing.
And so it's a different department. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The Rangers department is the one we were originally supposed to play. Now it's expanding. And it's only because they know that Nick Fish is their boss. And they don't like him either.
You think that's why they're going to play?
Why else would they play?
Oh, maybe they... So people are using their freedom of speech here to say that
everybody
maybe
knows
they
Nick Fish
don't
is a jack off. Everybody knows.
They
I'm
don't
sorry
agree.
To be so, you know, blunt about it, but believe me, I've yet to meet somebody that is really a true believer in Nick Fish. I've heard people say, well, he was great with spending that, you know, money and getting all that money together for that, or he built this big thing over here. But honestly, you know.
How hard is it to write a check when you've got money coming in?
If you're a developer,
it's not like you did
you should be the, you know, his job is sort of look out for housing, and I think that as the commissioner of housing, for you to go ahead and sit idly by for years and years while thousands and thousands of people lose their homes from Wells Fargo and the others and all these other big corporate conglomerates are just... what they're doing is they're coming to people like him, his higher-ups, and they're writing legislature. And then they're bringing it to these people that we hire to represent us and making laws. So these people don't even have to do anything anymore. They're just waiting for other people to come up with ideas, and they'll pass it through, and that's about it. And then they'll get all sorts of money, you know, campaign. Here's one that I noticed about Nick Fish.
Okay, I'm listening. I'm going to get confused.
There's an engineering company. This is what I thought I see anyway. I'm not saying any names, but there's this engineering company that
those things are nasty.
They're wet.
Is there one in the box? Check the box. Green box. Check the box. Sorry, Mike.
No,
go
it's
ahead.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I think I've said enough.
Really?
Yeah, I'm tired.
Oh. Well, it was very cool. And see if I can hook Antonio up with a blanket. The green box, Antonio, says Occupy Portland. Not the newspaper box that says Tribune.
Yeah, everybody put their blankets away, webs.
Okay. Well.
I think that's the greatest part about it. Like.
Do you get a hookup?
Thank you.
How is that?
What?
How is that one? Is it wet?
It's good.
It's good. So you're borrowing.
Mm-hmm.
Are you staying the night?
Yeah. Do you have some? Thank you, Mary. Who's online?
It's one of the channels of
Occupy.
The live stream. We have two channels, you know, on live stream.
Nice.
Yeah, these are not what's in here. I mean, this is the wrong package. These are Tia's Salsa Picante. They're basically Doritos, but non-GMO.
I figure out what I really want to do.
Uh-oh.
If I was able to build it.
What I Want to Do by Antonio, which changes a lot, but... Okay.
No, it isn't. It's just trying to cluster the right words together.
Okay.
To what I'm trying to say. I really like to build off-grid social organizations.
What does that mean?
How society is conducted, like how we use things. Off-grid social organization. Kind of like permaculture immersed with architecture. Have everything we need with one building. What I really like to do. Most of the stuff we build, like this building here, it doesn't properly dispose of waste. What it could do instead, what I've been reading, because I've been really big into airships, but it could do instead, not actually dispose of the waste it put out, but create energy with it in the building.
Okay.
Yeah. Things like that. That's off-grid social organization.
Huh.
And,
well, my, I have a farmer friend who's trying to become net zero for energy. Where he's got wind power and lots of stuff. So, despite the fact that he uses some fertilizer, which takes nitrogen from oil, you know, he uses a lot of other kinds of fertilizer. But, yeah, I mean... He's attempting, and he's getting close. He'll probably go this year if he hasn't already.
I really like to see all city designs do this. Or retrofit buildings that exist already to perform this way.
Are you talking about LEED cert?
LEED? I don't know. I don't like LEED. Because LEED is advocating for people to use resources that are not... reusable. They're just using resources that are not used. Just creating more waste. I'm not for that. I'm for buildings that dispose of waste or properly use them in the buildings themselves. If that makes any sense. Yeah. Like I said, permaculture and architecture together. Yeah.
I dig permaculture.
I mean, as far as I understand, you're talking about something where the garden will continue. The garden will continue. It's not that you have to continuously put inputs in. You're using its own bug killer, its own, you know, weed control. It's got its own, you know, dealing with water and dealing with getting the amount of sunlight because you've planted correctly and these are natural, local plants and systems.
It would really radicalize cities' way of doing things. Like, for example, another way of thinking about it, another thing I'm thinking about, is all buildings would have food growing on the walls.
Huh? Oh, that's a Star Trek, man.
Huh? Yeah. But that would be a, you know, our effort now is not to continue.
Some of us really are trying to sleep, and her yelling was just as annoying as I talking all night.
You were standing up for her.
I am standing up for her because okay. She would like to sleep for her mind.
So do we.
I know, but it's really funny. That's
yeah.
Fabulous.
Yeah. I'll start screaming if it helps, you know.
Huh.
But anyway,
people can move away. I mean,
yeah, that's like.
And you hear what once a week?
What, the long?
You know, she was just defending you. She was trying to help.
No, I meant we can move away. No.
Jeez.
No, I'm saying we
such
can
an ego.
Actually, that brings.
She was actually.
Those areas down there are quieter. This area right here is more social. Down there is quieter. People who want to sleep should probably.
Anyway, that's what I'm trying to like really talk about.
Yeah.
So, if that makes any sense, yeah.
Yeah.
That would, you know, I don't think our pace, I don't think if we're going to be sustainable, it's not speeding things up. It's like, it's really about slowing down real fast and finding ways that we can use buildings that help us and not make us dependent on the grid. Yeah. That'd be a beautiful city.
Well, we already have a lot of roofs that have greenery on top.
Yeah.
You know, and there's some filtering going on, and
yeah.
There's more and more. There's the semi-permeable cement going in, or not cement, asphalt going in. People are learning about runoff and how damaging it is from parking lots and trying to rectify that, you know. And
we need to go faster.
We have to do more of that, but it takes money.
Yeah, if money is going to be your answer to how we're going to survive the apocalypse that's coming, we should just quit.
The renovations that you're talking about doing, retrofit, that costs money.
Yeah.
So it would take the priority from taxpayers. Those kinds of things would have to be prioritized by other people, which means that they would have to want it badly enough to fork up the money and to cut other programs or other.
Yeah, it would also affect the farmers too.
In what way?
Because most of the food would be in the cities. Detroit is taking a really gradual step toward this possibly. One man is building farms in the city and not outside of it. I think we should be doing something like that real soon. On the way back.
Kelly?
Huh?
Garden team is putting a lot of food in the city.
Yeah. I think when I was on the way back home, I was thinking about the water content in the U.S. 93% of it's polluted. Yeah. And if we just
and now we got aluminum falling from the sky thanks to this frickin'.
And that, you know, aluminum. Monoxides and all that stuff in the air. It's how we use energy to transport goods and services to the cities. By doing off-grid social organizations, that would reduce the impact even on our health. Every time the environment's exploited, so is our rights.
I can't stay and help because I'm so busy. When I'd have 3 to 5 people, of 30 to 40 people, come stay for a bit. 40 people a night to go to. Maybe 3 would stay to help.
Yeah, I thought I'd share that.
You know, that was
along those lines. Fortunately, I don't have a lot of money to do something like that.
I have worked for 20 years of my life. I know why this revolution is happening. You know, because
I think what we're talking about would be the revolution.
You know, there are families out in the street suffering all the time. But, and I'm...
I hope people catch on with this. There's a lot of abandoned towns, and maybe a few cities in the Cascade region. It'd be good to use those spaces to create social organization for Cascadia, and perhaps organize off-grid buildings that do such things.
And
the surplus of resources we will have because of the space we utilize, we can share those resources cooperatively and continue that, you know, that mission. I'm really excited. Hopefully, we get enough resources.
Well, I'd like to see food on walls for sure.
Yeah.
That's so rad. I've seen those gardens, those vertical gardens.
Yeah.
There's several. There's kind of moss-lined trays that hang up, and you can, you know, some of them look like a utility belt almost. You know, the way they hang in. And they make sure to, you know, keep the water from spilling in your house. So you can do that. And then there's the bottle gardens. Have you seen those?
No.
Take 2-liter bottles and they cut it in such a way that, you know, it's got a pump, like a fish pond or whatever, you know, goes and takes the bottom and puts it back up to the top. And these little gardens, you know, of amazing capacity in these little spaces.
Right.
And we're learning how to use space.
Yeah, space is really key. Like, you know, for me, 200 years ago, to look at it my way, people were fighting over land from technocrats, like rich elitists. And today, we really have to, like, break our policies in architecture and building codes to perform the next step. Because there's not enough land to use space to provide food and all that stuff. We have to use buildings.
I swear to God, every time you step to the right, and I keep moving the camera, and by the time we're done, you're going to be around 360.
I really would like to do that. I don't know if I can get paid for it, but that'd be really cool. That's what I really want to do. I've been wanting to do this for like 3 years. It doesn't have to be earth shifts. It could be the principles of it.
Hey. Well.
I got scratched by Liberty.
Scratched?
Yeah. Oh, well. I don't know why I spelled it up. I'm not tired.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry that happened.
No, it's okay.
So, I wanted to thank you for what you're doing. I was saying if everybody had something once a week, how cool would that be?
Yeah, I'm so glad that you're doing it. I'm really excited.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
So I want to tell you that I'm getting ready. I believe somebody is going to donate and we are going to have it. I'm going to get a trailer built. Wow. A trailer, like a bike trailer, like a boat trailer.
Yeah.
To put in a parking spot.
Uh-huh.
Lock down carts like Mr. 60's. He'll build one or two or three more.
Uh-huh.
We'll have more sleeping bags. We'll have places for food type, you know, stuff like staples, water. You know, I mean, pans for water and heaters, and then we'll have our info booth on that. We'll lock it down here at night, and during the day, when the parking starts, put those carts, as long as they're on wheels, we're okay, as long as people are here. Put the carts out, have our occupation thing, have our, community needs, get that started again, maybe some art. And then wheel that trailer across the Hawthorne.
Cool.
So I'm hoping to do that, and I'm asking people to support it by taking the Twitter or just the link of Ustream where it has Vigil TV and sending that out, because Vigil TV has a link for the WePay.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm serious, I've got to get something more sustainable than me coming down with $60 a week. That's bull. We have to have a way, because I mean, right now I'm washing a few blankets. Do you know how much nicer it would be if we could keep many blankets in circulation and washing and drying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean,
I have a washer and dryer. I would love to help out with that.
That would be rad.
Yeah. We can even ask...
Do you have the ability to wash these things here?
I do.
Probably. If I could fit it in my cart tomorrow, I can, when I leave, to take dishes home.
Oh.
Yeah.
You're rad. Especially after all you've done tonight. I mean,
I love stuff like this.
Well, I could do this, except I have trouble getting it on my cart.
Yeah.
But the other thing is, I'm not back for until tomorrow, because it's the morning of, so I'm saying, you know, tomorrow.
Are you doing council meeting tomorrow? Or council?
Doing what?
The council tomorrow.
What's council?
They go in front of Sam Adams and Amanda Fritz and they...
City Council.
Yeah, yeah.
Who is doing that?
Monica and, oh my gosh, I forgot her name. They're going to go up and do a speech to them. It's going to be awesome. About police accountability and then a couple other stuff. So.
Oh, I want to tell El Damien, thank you for the notify. My data plan goes to 5 now. I expanded it. And I just reached that. So, if you can hear me, that is why our video is frozen. Really bummer, but this is Marjorie, who did the food tonight and is doing it every Tuesday and just volunteered to wash, and so did Antonio. Yeah, so here's the thing. We need it every day. So if somebody were to do laundry.
Oh, laundry, okay.
So if somebody were to do even days and somebody did odd days or... Split the week somehow.
Yeah, I could do that.
That would be rad.
If people want to donate laundry money.
Yeah.
Because it gets, it gets difficult.
If I get donations, I will pony up if people are doing laundry. Right now I'm doing them for free, right?
Yeah.
But it takes 2 days to do it. If we had multiple people doing it, it wouldn't be a problem for it to take 2 days.
It'll cost like $6 to do a laundry man because they have big washers. And if anybody wants to donate money, that'd be good, because I would be okay to go wash it.
Right. You know? Well, I will give you an allowance of laundry for sure if I get donations tonight, tomorrow, next day.
And I think,
because I've been asking people, I've been seriously asking people for cash right now, because we do have an occupation, we do have all these needs, and we're, you know, even though we're Occupy Portland occupation, we don't have any resources from, quote, Occupy Portland.
Yeah.
At our disposal,
have
unless...
Have people brought this up to them? Has anyone brought it to any meetings, or...?
I went to spending committee once.
Yeah.
And they said that they probably could help, and then they said no, so...
Why?
Because the things I was asking for was candles, coffee, and transportation, because I was here every other day, and I was doing laundry, and I was bringing coffee, and that took my transportation, right? Because I'm in Clackamas.
You should protest, because I saw them give money to Blue Hair Mike, for court fees.
I love him.
Yeah. And mentioned it to the group and tell him I said it. And also mentioned that Antonio said that he'd come to you for a parking fee to help out for this lady who brought stuff to Occupy Portland because it belonged to us.
Mm-hmm.
And they said no.
Right. I know that they have a process for, and one thing that Ajamu said is that he wanted to change the process, and I think they have. I went in before that was changed. Now, if you want a budget, you have to go in front of the GA. So you have to bring your proposal to the GA.
You should definitely bring one.
I thought that since we were already approved by the GA, and they know that it's a cost, they know it's an occupation, that we would have some funds of some kind.
Yeah.
I only ask for $35 a week. I'm putting in 60. You know, I'm working freaking 70 hours. That's less than $1 an hour of me asking to give back. So, you know, and part of that, I increase my expenditure in order to do this, in order to find funds. Because after me, when I quit doing this, or when I come back, you know, down in hours, everybody can do Vigil TV. Anybody who can get an Android phone. So if we had a fund for a data plan, we could share an Android. There's no reason that this has to be just me.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I would really like to get a partner to do Vigil TV, and that would be super easy.
Yeah.
And we just hook into the same channel.
Yeah.
And so if anybody has an Android phone and they want to do it, you know, let's do it.
Yeah, that's
same, but I'm really glad. So we just got something awesome here, which is you can do laundry. So
yes.
You can do it for free? Or
yes.
Do you have to pay?
Well, we are renting a house.
El Damien, I know that the video is frozen. And what we're hearing from Marjorie and Antonio, but the reason is that my data plan caps at 5G. I just reached it. I just got a notify. So this is what we have, and I'm sorry.
Do you see what it's frozen on?
No, it looks fine from here.
But they can't see.
Okay. No, they can't see. Anyway, Oh, here comes the bike again. Oh my God. Hey, Damien, one question. There he goes.
Yeah. Woohoo!
Neil. Hi, Neil.
We got people trying to sleep.
Oh, yeah.
He could turn it down.
Poor guy. We love the music, but they're sleeping.
Hey,
buddy.
Did you walk her somewhere?
No.
Sorry about that.
Is she okay?
I don't care.
Okay.
So here's a question for you, El Damien. Does the picture sometimes change, or is it the same picture that was 10 minutes ago?
We're still riding around.
I'd love to know.
Yeah.
Neil's here with his
Tuesday night. Well,
Tuesday night.
Wednesday morning.
This is rad.
That's coming soon, right? This is Wednesday morning, actually, isn't it? So, I'm ready.
Are you all coming tomorrow to City Hall? I hope so. That's really good news to hear about.
Well, that's later today, actually, and it's going to be a...
Have you been to our vigil?
No.
This is for the houseless community's right to have, such as they do, sleeping bags. Normally they're pestered all night and can never sleep, but so far our protest people are actually getting in.
That's great.
Okay.
Yeah, we're not from here visiting, so.
Yeah, there's a hearing.
Right. It's cool to see.
Monica.
Well, we're going to have a, let's see, June 10th, there's going to be a picnic. Where?
Right there?
Right there?
Yeah.
June 10th.
Okay.
So come to that.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Hey, take care. Lots of bubbles.
Lots of bubbles and food.
Yeah.
Pulled pork.
Bring the bubbles.
Anyway.
Yeah, there'll be bubbles.
I just asked, we have a viewer who's communicating with me about the frozen screen, and I just asked if the picture shifts or if it's just the same one from like 20 minutes ago. So, feedback, Mr. El Damien or Mrs. El Damien. Anyway,
keep up the good work.
So, anyway, okay. So, what are we doing? Oh yeah,
laundry.
Is yours free?
No, I mean, we pay for a water bill at
okay.
my house, so
okay.
that would, but it's, yeah, it's fine. I mean, I wouldn't be able to do it, like, every single night, but I definitely, I mean, I want to help.
That's cool.
People need clean.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like it, so.
So you could take these tomorrow?
Yeah, I can take them tomorrow morning, yeah. After the council, I'll definitely take them tomorrow.
That's fantastic,
yeah.
Because then the next day,
I
can see, how could I do this? If we were to do it so that I actually did every other night with you or Antonio, that would work out really well. I can do them. I can do the laundry on the even mornings when I leave of the month. I can take whatever's here. So if you were to be here on odd mornings and take whatever's here, then we'll start to have a rotation.
Okay.
You know, where two blankets go out and then the next day two other blankets come in, and that would be fantastic.
Okay. I'm not sure if I could, like, I would definitely have to speak with my family about, because it is, we finding out how expensive it is for the water
bill. Well, here's the thing. I might be able to find money for that.
Yeah.
He's talking about using CoinOp, I think.
I could even do that. I mean, I bet there are laundromats downtown. That would be way easier just to, like, go make a run and come back instead of, like, because I live all the way up on 84th between Burnside and Division.
If you guys want to drop by your house.
Yeah,
Anyway, so yeah, I will try. I will check and see if we got any tonight. And if so, then as soon as 2 days from now, I'll be able to come with some laundry money.
Cool, okay.
Since that's the first thing that we're getting help with,
uh-huh,
officially from people, that is the first thing I will put donations toward.
Cool, okay. And I'll be here every Tuesday night anyway, so maybe even, be like food and laundry.
Food and laundry. Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Especially this laundry.
I bought these two pieces.
Food and laundry.
So, yeah, no, I just love the fact that we have something every Tuesday to look forward to. And if we had something different every day of the week that somebody brought here, you know,
like,
wouldn't that be wonderful?
Wise?
No.
Oh.
Like occupy wise.
Yeah.
Like, let's say you're here on Tuesday. What if you had a friend who is Wednesday and set up a community needs day?
Yeah.
And we could all save up throughout the week and bring stuff here.
Yeah.
And flyer around town all week as we can to say, come to City Hall on Wednesday for community needs. If you need shoes, we need socks.
That's a great idea. That's a really, really great idea.
We just need one person to do it and a person to make some flyers, and we can do that.
Antonio was doing bubbles earlier, and I came up with the idea that I really wanted to do, like, an activity night out here sometimes. Because, we could get like a projector and show a movie, and we could do like arts and crafts and everything. It'd be great. Yeah.
That's wonderful.
What's that?
You know,
oh,
Ivan.
Yeah. You were like looking at me, and I was like talking, and I was like, oh, what do I say? For some reason, it choked me.
I was listening to the music.
Oh, the music.
I was putting on my hat.
But you're smiling. It's very suspicious.
You have to watch him on Vigil TV because there's one called Fun with 99 and Tim. I laughed my ass off when I watched it. It was just, there was nothing happening except the three of us just BSing and everybody was sleeping. And most of it's, you know, like a little bit more substantial, but sometimes there's just pure
food service.
Total silliness. I love it.
Yeah, it's so
make
funny.
Make one that's specifically built to be a sound trailer.
I had some joke. It started out, it was like a... Oh, okay.
What's up?
We have 5 minutes, and sometimes like there'll be a picture that'll hold for like 5 minutes, and then other times it'll be like every second there'll be a video for a little change, you know, like a strobe going on. So there is some video, but my data plan capped 5, and I don't know how to. I was worried about that. I was like, am I gonna use it up? What's the date today?
That's very, very good.
Yeah,
question.
I mean, it's the 5th or 6th now, I think. And so that means that it can't be on a monthly cycle. There's no way I used at the beginning of the month to now.
No, I think it's technically the 7th, maybe.
Oh, okay.
I don't know.
No, it's got to be the 6th.
Yeah, okay. If it's Wednesday, it's the 6th?
So,
okay.
The thing is I must be nearing my end, so I should be getting my video back soon. I hope that I'm toward the end of my cycle. Because if I went through this in 6 days, I'm in trouble. I know I couldn't have.
You mean the data usage?
Mm-hmm.
How much you got?
The bike trailer?
5 gigs. That's what, I don't know what that means, but even
that's
though,
a lot.
But I use it real fast.
But
now they don't see anything but a still. Like sometimes for 5 minutes at a time, it's one picture, no video, essentially.
Oh, yeah. Is that not what they're supposed to be seeing?
They're supposed to be seeing a video.
A moving picture, like.
Yeah. See.
And then what you're saying, they see this.
Yeah. To them, there's no difference in what you just did.
Okay. Oh, right. Not yet.
Not yet. Yeah, you might actually see a shot of 99's hand, and I don't charge you for that. That's for free.
Oh, they can hear us?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I'm
hey,
actually
right
talking
on.
To that. Look at that. See? One giving us a feedback.
Sometimes a 1 second video flash.
Yeah.
Oh, so hey, they going to really flip out when they see the hand. Whoa!
They're gonna flip out.
What's that? Oh, it's the hand. Oh, a colored one.
Yep. That's what they think.
It's a chocolate hand.
You got a baby face, kind of. You know that? Right? You got like soft, nice skin. Oh, skin. Oh, how you do that. I hope I look as good as you when I go like that.
So. Oh, yeah, you will.
Yeah.
Right on.
Yeah.
No hardcore drugs.
No.
You know, I drink, I eat healthy now. I started eating healthier.
Yeah.
Good for you.
And then, like, I'm for real.
I mean,
so
you got
sleep.
Nice hair. Look at that. You take care of yourself, man.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah. I have to, yeah. Man. Otherwise, you know, I'll look like...
If he's drunk, don't talk to him. He's mean.
Like 100 years old.
Yeah.
For real.
That's a little tip.
So for sure, man. So, but...
You're adorable. Look at you. Oh, man. If they wait 5 minutes, they'll see this. That is so cute. You look like a China doll. Like, there's another little one inside of you.
No, it's a Russia doll.
A Russia doll.
Oh, Russia doll. Well, another Marjorie inside.
You knew what she was
Yeah. And she serves every Wednesday.
Russia doll's
Tuesday.
No, I'm saying the little one.
Oh, yeah.
They have a different one.
Oh, right. Yeah. Yeah.
Wouldn't that be great?
That would be great. Because I'd be like, weren't you just here yesterday?
Yeah. Except you're bigger.
Yeah. You're Wednesday, Marjorie.
These are the intelligent conversations we have. No, because why aren't you here?
As long as it's food, I mean, I wouldn't care if it was Tuesday. I just know. Oh yeah, it's Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
Or
there's
you know,
more than one person making
Tuesday.
Except the servings are smaller too, and that's a bummer.
Oh right.
Yeah. Little Marjorie.
We'd have to check on that. We'd have to fix that.
And little Marjorie, they're even smaller portions.
It's too busy actually.
It's the only problem.
Hey, you guys ought to come out here on Tuesdays at around 6 because the meals are starting to get more and more creative.
Oh yeah, like what? Like what? Like what?
Oh, I did
today
tacos.
Was taco.
Today.
Oh yeah, I heard vegan
tacos.
Vegan
yeah.
tacos.
I like that stuff.
DIY.
Yeah.
Well,
I
did it, and then later on I got to DIY.
What's that?
Do it yourself.
Oh, I knew that.
Serve it. But you were originally doing it.
Oh well, yeah. No, you got it. If you guys, if you don't do that, and you let other people do that, remember, this is just food for thought. Half of us don't wash our hands. So I'm just saying, you know, hey, I love the trust factor. You know, they put a spoon in my hand and say that, and that. And I'm like, okay.
Actually, you guys, if you look at the video, it says funny at the end. I have a video that says funny at the end because that's a scene where 99 gets his germ on. Do you remember when you were showing the germiness of shelters and you did this like 5 minute mime of all the ways that he's like wiping his nose on his sleeve and he's like doing this.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my God, it was so gross. I had to have a shower after watching this. And he was just kept going. You guys have to watch that video.
You got to, yeah.
So
no,
funny.
You
the other video, Marjorie, the very first thing you
of
hear.
Everything around you. For real, I'm not even lying.
The video I'm talking about, the one that says fun with 99 and Tim.
Yeah.
It starts out with me going, so there was a guy and he was holding a pile of shit in his hand. And he goes, look what I almost stepped in. And that's how the video starts. I'm just like, you know, my aunt's gonna watch Vigil TV and, like, look at the humanitarian mission I'm on and go, what?
That's great. Yeah. Because you know what? Some, what are we called? Activists, but they're not the activists. They're the radical as activists, like the ones that was with Patty Hearst. Now, those guys, hey, they were robbing banks, okay? And they were sign holders, you know, we want this, we want that. And they were bank robbers.
You should get that to tequila.
Could you see?
For the champ committee.
No, yeah. Could you see a sign holder with a gun?
We did this, we robbed banks.
No, it wouldn't say that. It, you know, whatever the sign says, you know.
Wouldn't that be really
we want this,
though?
And we want that, and we'll rob banks.
No, that's what they were doing, though. For real, to fund their whatever their belief. Those guys were robbing banks, you know. I mean, look at what they do. They tried to
like using my strength.
They tried to say that they kidnapped Patty Hearst, right?
What we're trying to say is, please go to Vigil TV WePay account, or we'll have to rob a bank and kidnap Patty Hearst.
No, no, we will not do that. We will not do that, people.
Is Patty Hearst alive?
No, no. I'm going to say one of the people that was in on that deal, they just got her, like, I'm going to say about last year, about a year and a half or 2 years ago. She just came out of hiding. She was like, you know, and they gave her, like, she was here in Oregon, like here in a little town in Oregon and stuff. She was one of the main people that,
she went to jail, right?
Yeah, but not for, I'm going to say, because she was like, she had a good job, like she was a social worker or something, like a teacher.
Oh, wow.
She was a grandmother already. She lived a really productive life and stuff. And I think they gave her, like, they put her on probation. They put her on probation and then gave her like 30 days in jail. But she found an identity and ran with it. Ran with this identity and stuff, and then I forget how they found her. But she was one of the original people that was there at Patty Hearst with the Patty Hearst thing.
Oh, so you're not talking about Patty Hearst, you're talking about the lady.
Yeah, I'm talking about the lady that was one of the kidnappers and stuff. But so I mean, if she's still alive, Patty Hearst must still be alive, because they said she was part of the group, she was part of the gang, you know. She wasn't kidnapped. She was just a little rich girl whose daddy had money, and then you know, I don't want to say she fell in with the wrong crowd, but you know, hey, her belief put her in with a crowd that, you know, allowed her to exploit her status.
Well, I'm not going to kidnap Patty Hearst because,
well,
know, she's already gone through
no,
a lot.
No, you know, but no, it'd be
and
like,
I'm not going to rob a bank.
She didn't. No, that's what I'm saying. You have to be aware of everything around you. That's what we were talking about him. So. Yeah. But I know you guys ain't gonna rob a bank.
Okay. Yeah. I just want to say, you know, that's off the table. I mean, fundraising, you can't go crazy.
No, you can't go crazy. You know, but that's how they were doing it back in the days, you know. You know, they, I guess, you know, cake walks and stuff was too slow in fairs. You know, that brought the community together. You know, that.
Is that really is that really the options? They were like,
okay,
we gotta raise some money.
Yep.
We could have a cake walk.
Right.
And we could rob a bank.
Right. I'm gonna say back in the day, yes.
That's their meeting.
That's how they fund. Yeah, that's how they needed weapons. What was gonna buy weapons? They didn't have rich parents.
In that meeting, the first part of the meeting, they had to decide that. Yeah. Second part of the meeting, they were like, okay, so we'll either need a frosting gun,
right? What the action is gonna be? Yeah. What the action is gonna be? And all of them gonna get them. They gonna get enough money to where they can go purchase.
Did they hurt people? Patty Hearst gang.
We don't know. I mean, just we'd have to pull up all the banks that they were suspected of robbing. And did anybody get hurt in any of those robberies? And if they did, answer your question. Yes, they did hurt people. You know.
Yeah. I just can't imagine fundraising by robbing banks.
Well, I mean,
that was before WePay.
You know, the radicals back in that day is a lot different than the radicals today. And even still, like the white supremacist groups, you know,
they have a WePay.
A few years ago, they was robbing armored cars. You know, so
what are they doing now?
Well, the thing about it is, why were they robbing armored cars? That's it. You know, they were doing that for the money. And what were they going to do with that money? And that money was to build probably bigger compounds, buy more land, and put weapons on them.
Freaky.
And
Those guys are creepy.
I say bold. You know, they, hey, you know, it's how you get your message across. You know, you're still in the same boat. You're protesting something that you don't like about the government. Bottom line, the government is the enemy, and he's everybody's enemy. Whether he's your enemy, your neighbor's, the white supremacist's enemy, or the church's enemy, he's the enemy, you know?
That's the protest.
Yeah, and that's a protest, right. Right, and everybody, is how whatever form of protest, and some people do it, that's why they call them radicalists, you know? Because they do it a lot different, like, hey, you know, we're coming in, we're going to kick your door open, and we're going to kick you in your ass, you know? That's those are messages, you know?
Yeah, that is a message.
You know, you come painful in with a message. Sign, you come in with a sign that says, we want equality, and you got guns in your hand. Whew.
The great equalizer.
Yeah, hey, the message is going to be gotten across somehow, for real. People are going to read that sign, and they're going to be looking at your guns, and they're going to say, damn, these people mean business.
Yeah, but do you really listen to anybody who has to use a gun to get a message, you know?
Hey, that's why, you know, Iraq, dude, he turned those, he turned fire on the oil fields. Best time to do this. Wow, no one's beating.
I heard that.
I mean, it depends.
You know it is. I gotta write something up about it.
Sorry for the paperwork.
Yeah, it's fine. It's like I was telling folks when it happened. I don't like to piss in your guys' Cheerios. I like you guys to take care of your own like that. But if someone does something stupid like that, I have to write it.
What happened? Did I miss something?
Some gal tried to steal her headband and then.
Oh, and okay.
Stupid.
Oh,
yeah. She's. That was your headband. Yeah, she took my headband.
I thought it was the guy's headband.
No, she took it, and then I, like, grabbed her to get it back, and then I, like, yeah, and then she scratched me, and then I yelled at her to stop harassing people.
Oh, okay.
And then she saw
I
you,
saw
and then
that.
Took off.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. I'm sorry about
sorry
that.
About the drama.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
Hey, it doesn't affect me any. I mean.
Yeah, but it's just, well. So
we don't want you to have to write paperwork up on it.
Yeah, exactly.
It's fine. It makes me look good.
Right on. Yeah.
Well, no one else will do reports. They'll be like, oh, I'm not going to do this. I go to my boss and I go, here you go. You
here
know,
you
Gary
go.
Loves
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
Oh, Gary probably loves reports. Mr.
Oh,
Train
yeah.
likes reports.
Absolutely.
He likes rules.
He shows that we're doing something.
He likes rules and order. Yes, it is.
Shit.
And you know who else watches this? The police.
Oh, really? Oh, well, yeah. Go ahead and take me off of there.
I can't. It's live.
Oh.
So if you see the green box, run away. Sorry about that.
No worries.
Anyway, this is Morris talking.
I'm going to say that's assumed that the pigs are watching it.
Can we eat vegetables that much?
I wouldn't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wouldn't either.
For anything else that I've seen enough people sneak over there to use that place as their bathroom,
I'm
that
not,
I wouldn't trust anything growing over there.
I wouldn't eat them.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
I never thought about that.
What?
Whoops.
Oh yeah. For real.
They're growing garlic. I want to go check. Can I? I want to go.
Where is it?
Right here. Can I see?
Yeah. Here's the thing.
I'm
going to say
the lady said
what they're growing out there, they kept letting it go to seed. And like
yeah.
three different crops they came and ripped out, and nobody can eat it. And it's like, what kind of message is this? Here at City Hall, we're asking you to take care of poor people, and you let food be grown out here, thrown away after telling everybody they can't have it. I'm like, no, that can't be. So I called some people about that.
Did you find out about that? Because I've never known what they do with that, with those vegetables.
Well, apparently they grow them and throw them away.
They do. See, I just kind of figured they don't anymore.
Well, okay. When you let lettuce go to seed or any other plant just bolt, you know, it's not edible anymore. I guess it's edible, but it's bad. And then, you know, those are plants that are renewable. Like you pick the leaves and then it grows some more, you know, or you take it. But
yeah.
This is, you know, they're just uprooted all at once. And I'm like, really? Is that doesn't look like they used it. It looked like it was a seed. So anyway, Well,
that's a waste.
I have no idea.
That's what seems to be happening, and I take exception to it because this isn't a private space. And if you're going to garden and it says better together garden, share your harvest on it and all this stuff, and then people can't eat it.
Well, I'm not the guy who can tell you you can take anything. Sorry.
Right, no. I know. No, they know. As far as I know, we can't, except 99 actually talked to the lady planting. Yeah. And she said, sure.
Really?
So, you know, so he can. He can. Maybe he'll share. But yeah. Anyway. Yeah, I think the fact that people, I'm sorry that, yeah, I wouldn't want to use that. I wouldn't want to eat there. I washed the, I ate a few leaves off of the, what do you call it, the chard, and I washed it. But, you know, that wasn't good enough in light of thinking about it now. Human health, health and safety.
The houseless people wouldn't pick a lot of it. So she did say you could eat off of this, but I wouldn't recommend it because, like dude said, I done seen many people go in there and think they're not being seen and just pull Willie out.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, that's what I tell them. I just say, hey, man, you know, dude, do you guys know we eat that shit? And, oh, really? Oh, I'm...
Maybe they can't tell us. Well, those over there aren't, haven't flowered yet. I wonder if we could.
No, she just put those in.
Oh, great.
All the little ones? Yeah, look. All the little ones? She just put those in. All the other stuff is old stuff.
Wait, why would she? Oh, you mean she planted them as seeds?
No, they. See the little ones? She bring them in as little ones, just like that.
Uh huh. Oh, okay. Cool.
Yeah. And then she
brought, an interesting setup.
Brought the dirt in to make the little, raise the little beds. All the dirt is new.
What is the, what is the foam do?
So. She's live streaming.
Hmm?
It holds it.
Hey, what
it
are you
holds
eating?
It in place.
Oh,
yep.
The foam.
Tortillas and beans.
Right on.
He's like, wait a minute, you got something good?
I'm excited. This is like another step.
Yeah,
every Tuesdays.
Yeah, I'm really excited.
I want Food and Garden Club to like do like a vegetable drop.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be great? Yeah, that would be. We have vegetable fruit drop Wednesdays.
That'd be amazing.
Wouldn't that be awesome?
Yeah, I could use those and cook those too.
Yeah.
I haven't been working.
So they should do it on Monday.
Yeah.
We should have it on Monday and then anything left over we should try to make a meal out.
Girl, your hands are too delicate to just touch something with meat on it, huh?
No, it's not that.
I will
what?
Keep you in mind for sure.
Don't harass me about not cooking meat.
I'm not a...
Uh-huh.
Well, first off, I'd like to say the health department was harassing me, and things with animal products expire much faster.
But it'd get eaten before it...
Yeah,
whatever.
I personally don't eat meat, but that's my personal choice, and I'm not saying that anyone else can't eat meat. But I don't want to cook it, and I don't want to get in trouble for it expiring, and
that's
I don't want to get anyone in trouble.
That's why I
but
was asking.
But 99 takes care of the meat.
The hands.
Oh, then
he,
if
too...
you want to cook meat and serve meat, feel free.
No, I didn't say that. I was saying you're the cook.
Yeah, but you do some mean cooking.
You should do the meat.
We could have you calling
again. I
was
going out on a limb and saying, well, she's the cook. She's the cook. She's the cook. She's the cook. Cook, 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 cook.
There goes the...
How many cooks was that?
You just,
well, just
that was a lot of
fun. Yeah, just to let them know that, get, hey, they are, I'm the cook, you know?
I'm the cook of vegetables and other.
So thus, delicate hands is too delicate to cook anything that's meat, so.
I'm just going to ignore you now.
Animal welfare, one of the ways to be good to animals is to not eat them, for example.
Hey, well,
also be good to humans.
Either way,
I can't store anything out here.
He's part of the food chain.
Without expiring.
That animal is part of the food chain.
I eat meat. I eat meat that's been sourced with humane conditions, and I really like animal welfare. That do you know there's a I went to OSALT, OSALT, Oregon Sustainable Agriculture Land Trust.org. So it's like salt with the O in front of it. www.vigilcitytv.org. And they have this whole, like, link thing.
They've been trying to sleep in the, like, right next to your company.
No, I think they just said you just had, I think they just had to go to the bathroom.
Okay, well, no, I mean earlier she was kind of upset with
that. Well, this is the wrong space.
Yeah, this is the wrong place to be trying to sleep.
I mean, over there and over there.
So when you're homeless, I mean, I told Mary this one time. When you're homeless and stuff, this is it. This is it right here, okay? You think a truck is going to care if you're asleep? Oh, there's somebody sleep on it. Let me turn the engine off and roll by.
That's very nice of them.
Yeah, it doesn't happen.
That doesn't happen. You think that ambulance?
Yeah, but all I'm saying, is the sides of this occupation area are quieter.
Yeah.
This here is a social area.
Yeah, no, I agree with that. I think that they.
I mean, there is some degree of respect. That's only if you're in jail. But you're not in jail. You're outside. You're not behind four walls. You know, when you go in and lock your door, shut the window and stuff, you know, and you put those things out. But and really? When you're outside, what you do is you make your earplugs, temporary earplugs, bam, bam. Okay? But you're
they
not
just
gonna
want some beans and tortillas.
Is that what it's all about?
All you have to do is say it. You don't have to.
Yeah.
Yeah, it seemed like it was louder on purpose right through here.
Oh, yeah.
It was just bumping the siren up there, and then as soon as he went through this block, it was, like, solid.
He has to be, man. Hey, he's saying, hey,
if he can't sleep,
you know,
his neighbors
is waking him up, he'd be damned if he let the homeless sleep. Not on my watch. Hey, I'm a bell ringer. Beep, 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 beep. Wake up, people.
Seriously, some people are like that.
No, I'm serious. They are.
There is a car that comes through regularly, and I got his license plate, and I yelled it online. There was a company that came by and did that once, and I yelled the company name. I mean, what baloney.
They just make a bunch of extra noise on purpose?
Yeah.
Basically.
A whole block.
Late at night, they could get a citation for.
You could get a citation for that. Yes.
Misuse of a horn and disturbing the peace.
Disturbing the peace, yeah. But,
so, I think that needs to happen.
Yeah, somebody came
by. But I haven't
by,
seen him do it. Recently.
Yelled out his window, Daddy, I'm drunk! Good job, hippies!
Yeah, you're always gonna have that.
Hey, he said something like that. you couldn't understand what he was saying, but you knew he was upset.
Actually,
and
you know
he
what?
Was trying.
99 has a 99 has a word for that. It's called robble, robble, robble.
Yeah, hey, he robble, was trying robble, to get robble, in there. Robble, robble. Yeah, hey, dude, robbling, man.
He goes like this, robble this, robble that.
And that's what dude was doing, hey, but he was drunk. You could tell dude was really trying to get it out, man. And he was trying to get his grievance out at us while the car was going and then get it out, you know, and us hear it. But he was drunk. He was drunk and we were talking.
I wish he could have gotten pulled over. Hey, that would have been hysterical, because then he'd be off the road.
We was looking at dude, you know, we were looking at the guy, and then we was like, and then he was gone, still yelling down the road and stuff. And they said, did anybody catch that? Any of that, any part of what he said, man, we was like.
Robble this.
Yeah, no, that's what he did. He was like, because he says, like, I caught two words, y'all and job. I'm serious, he started yelling, coming through here, damn hippies, all the way down there, and from this to this, I only heard two words, y'all and job or something, you know.
Sounds like you heard hippies though too.
Well,
right?
No,
not really.
I threw that in there.
You threw that in there
because I, you know, because we was all we just busted up, man. It was like, did anybody get any of that? Because, you know, and I tried to be funny and say, I thought I heard the N-word. He was trying to call me the N-word, but didn't know how to say it while being drunk. You never, no, not go to sleep. Hey, what are you trying to say? You know, them, when you call them black people, you know, when you get real mad, what do you call them? You said nigger? Yeah, I was trying to say that.
But I was too fucking drunk and stupid.
I'm drunk. Hey, girl, what do you eat?
What he's eating.
Same thing. Really? This is what's on the menu.
Tortilla right now. Feel free.
All
right,
yeah.
Hello. How are you? Good.
Don't park in the middle of the road.
What's up? Oh, yeah, no. Oh, I know. Or, I mean, I figured. I'm white. Is it a reoccurring thing?
I'm not his dad. Whoa, you got hot sauce?
Shit, man.
My last couple bites here, I need to do that. Thank you.
Oh, my God, you do. Oh, I would love that.
Yeah, I can bring that for you guys. I brought it for me. You want on my tibet or dub.
Okay, I see how you are.
Oh, I mean, yeah, y'all can use it. Sometimes it's too hot for people. I just want to let them know because I don't get the fake stuff. Yeah, no, you know, hey, you know, people like, oh, he's a rock star. You know how people run to the car? I don't do that. I don't do that. He knows to park the car. He knows to park the car and get it. And
that's
if he
really
don't,
funny that you're saying that.
If he don't park the car and get it.
I was watching you too, and he was down there.
What?
A couple, like 5 days ago or something like that. He was down there.
Oh yeah, no.
He'd come over to his car.
Yeah. You know, get out the car. I don't do that no more. Yeah. You know, yeah. Get out the car. You ain't new here no more. You know, you better get out the car and interact and stuff. So.
Do you guys know who he is?
Yeah, he's if I believe him, he's a professional tennis player. Yeah.
So he kind of came out of the shell.
He's rich.
He's a rich kid's son. Yeah. He lives up on the northwest of Portland. And kind of a nerd's fault because he's nervous.
Yeah.
He needs to be normal. And 99 got him to come out and just talk and kind of relax.
Yeah.
And now he don't want to do it no more. So I don't know. My job's done. You know, he's a grown man.
You made that burrito a million times better.
Oops. Would you like coffee?
Coffee? No, thanks. I might still want to get some sleep pretty soon.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, so as I understand it, we're still froze, and probably not going to save this video unless I go back through. I might make a highlight. In fact, I'm going to do that with some of the videos that are long. Oh, there's my buddy, Tim. That's awesome. Hey, you. Tim. Tim. Hi. I was just signing off here.
Okay. Have a good night, everybody.